Yeah.
Hello guys, welcome to VLSA for All YouTube channel. In this series, we are covering digital interview topics. In this video, I want to tell about Boolean algebra and complement of a function. Let us see what is Boolean algebra and how to use Boolean algebra and what are the drawbacks of Boolean algebra and finally, what are the alternatives to this Boolean algebra. Set of rules used to simplify the given logic expression without changing its functionality, known as Boolean algebra. It is nothing but set of rules. And let us learn what are the rules and how to use them. And these rules are used to simplify or minimize the given logic expression. For that, we need to learn some identities. They are express 0 that is equal to x. This is identity law. And next one, x plus 1 that is equal to 1. This is dominance law. And next, x plus x that is equal to x. This is idempotent law. And next, x plus x bar is equal to 1. This is complement law. X plus y that is equal to y plus 6. This is commutative law. And next, x plus of y plus z that is equal to x plus y of plus z. This is associative law. Next, x of y plus z that is equal to xy plus xz. This is distributive law. And x plus y whole bar that is equal to x bar y bar. This is De Morgan's law. X bar whole bar that is equal to x. This is self double complement law. Similarly, we write these identities in product form. Let us see some examples. Here, a plus ab. By taking a as common, we get a of 1 plus b. We know identity that 1 plus b is equal to 1. Then our answer is a. We can easily simplify our expression using Boolean algebra. And next, second one, ab plus ab bar that is equal to, by taking a as common, we get a of b plus b bar that is equal to, we know that b plus b bar that is equal to 1. So a dot 1 is equal to a. And next one, a bar bc plus ac. Here by taking c as common, we get c of a bar b plus a. And then by using distributive law, we can write like this. And that our answer is a plus b whole of c. And next one, a bar b plus abc bar plus abc. Here first term we are writing like as it is. And next two terms we are taking ab as common and then c bar plus c that is equal to a bar b plus ab. By taking b as common, we get a bar plus a that is equal to b. These are few more examples. Our function is f of x comma y comma z is equal to x bar y plus y z bar plus y z plus x y bar z bar. Using idempotent law, we can write y z bar is equal to y z bar plus y z bar. Now interchange the second and third term, we get x bar y plus of y z bar plus y z plus of y z bar plus y bar z bar x. By using distributive law, we can write x bar y plus x of z bar plus z plus z bar of y plus x y bar. We know that z bar plus z that is equal to 1, and absorption law y plus x y bar is equal to y plus x. So we get x bar y plus x dot 1 plus z bar of x plus y. Since y dot 1 is equal to y, we can write x bar y plus x plus z bar of y plus x. And then we get y of x bar plus 1 plus z bar of y plus x. We can write y dot 1 plus z bar of y plus x, as we know x bar plus 1 is equal to 1. And again we can write y dot 1 as y and plus z bar of y plus x. Next, y plus yz bar plus xz bar. By taking y as common, we can write 1 plus z bar plus xz bar. Then we know that 1 plus z bar is equal to 1. So since we can write y dot 1 plus xz bar, this expression we can write as y plus xz bar. Hence, the simplified form of the given Boolean expression is y plus xz bar. Our next question is f of p comma q comma r, that is equal to of p plus q of p plus r. By using the distributive law, we can write as p dot p plus p dot r plus q dot p plus q dot r. Using idempotent law, we can write p plus p dot r plus q dot p plus q dot r. And again, using distributive law, we get p of 1 plus r plus q dot p plus q dot r. Using dominance law, we can write p plus q dot p plus q dot r. And again, using distributive law, we get p plus 1 dot p plus q dot r. Therefore, using dominance law, we can get the reduced form as 1 dot p plus q dot r. We can write p plus q dot r. Next, our question is x bar y bar z plus yz plus xz. By taking z as common, we can write z of x bar y bar plus y plus x. Now apply distributive law for the first two terms inside the bracket. Then we can get z of x bar plus y of y plus y bar plus x. We know that y plus y bar is equal to 1. Then we get z of x bar plus y dot 1 plus x. We can write this as z of x bar plus y plus x. We know that x plus x bar is equal to 1. Then we get z of 1 plus y. 1 plus y is equal to 1. So our answer is z. Hence the Boolean expression equivalent to z. Next question is a b bar of c plus bd plus a bar b bar whole to the c. Using distributive law, we can write as a b bar c plus a b bar bd plus a bar b bar whole to the c. Since we know that b b bar is equal to 0, we can write a b bar c plus 0 plus a bar b bar whole to the c. And next we can write a b bar c plus a bar b bar c. Now taking b bar c as common, we can write b bar c of a plus a bar. We can get a plus a bar is equal to 1. Then our answer is b bar c. This is our reduced function. Next question. Our function is a is equal to xy plus x of y plus z plus y of y plus z. Using idempotent law, we can write y dot y is equal to y. Thus, we get xy plus xz plus yz. Xy plus xy is equal to xy. We get xy plus xz plus yz. By taking y as common, we get xy plus xz plus y of 1 plus z. 1 plus z is equal to 1. So we can write xy plus xz plus y dot 1. Using identity law, 1 dot y is equal to y. So a is equal to xy plus xz plus y. By taking y as common, we can write y of 1 plus x, that is plus xz. 1 plus x is equal to 1. So y plus xz. This is our reduced function. And next question is, check whether AC plus ABC is equal to AC. Is true or false? By taking AC as common, we can write AC of 1 plus B, that is equal to AC. 1 plus B is equal to 1, since AC is equal to AC. Hence, the given equation is true. Till now, we have reduced any expression into reduced form. We have to do, after getting reduced to function, we have to write truth table. By using the truth table, we have to draw logic diagram. Here we are seeing that we got one function, that is f is equal to x plus y bar z. By this function, we are writing a truth table. Inputs are x, y, z and our output is f. Whenever the f is high, we are taking that inputs and using this truth table, we are drawing logic diagram. In this way, we can draw circuits using Boolean expression. And next, our concept is De Morgan's theorem. This theorem contains two main rules. One is x plus y bar x plus y whole bar that is equal to x bar y bar, and xy whole bar that is equal to x bar plus y bar. And these are some of basic examples using this theorem. And now next is complement of a function. It contains two rules. Those are, first one, in this complement of a function, we change plus operator as dot operator, and keeping complement function to that. Here, x1 plus x2 plus x3, so on, xn whole bar that is equal to x1 bar dot x2 bar dot x3 bar, so on, xn bar. And again, we can write as x1, x2, x3, so on, xn whole bar that is equal to x1 bar plus x2 bar plus x3 bar, so on, xn bar. In below, we are writing one example as if function is given as ab plus c bar d bar plus b bar d, then we are writing dot operator as plus and the variable which is not having complement, we are keeping that complement, and the variable which is containing complement, we are removing that complement. This is the complement of a function. Thank you.